I've been coming to South Bend for a long time. It's nice to be back. Hey, I had some big news since I was here. Caroline and I had a baby. How about that? Beautiful little girl named Ava Ray Economopoulos. Caroline has already explained to her that the Economopoulos is silent. It's very rewarding to be a father. You take a little crying person, you hold her and feed her, and then she's totally happy and content. And I've only known her for 13 months. I've known her mother for 6 years, and when she cries, I still have no idea what to do. I think I'm going to try burping her. I don't know. Mixed messages in the home, too, right? I change the baby, I'm a hero. I try to change Caroline, I'm an asshole. Very tricky. So the kid did not poop for 3 days in a row recently. Caroline's freaking out. I'm like, what are you freaking out about? This is like a dream come true. We have a baby that doesn't poop, honey. We win. This is like a seedless watermelon. We get a poopless dog, we're gonna have the perfect family. They warn you when you're becoming a dad, you'll never be number one in the eyes of the mother ever again. And I accepted that intellectually. If I did not know there was such a drop off from one to two. There's a giant tidal wave of love from mother to daughter. I get ocean spray, maybe. I was holding Ava in my lap and Caroline comes over and leans down. Oh my God, you're so cute. I love you more than anyone I've ever met. I can hear you. She looks up at me. Hey, don't forget batteries. Really, that's the gap we're working with now. And the battery jockey. Caroline said to me the other day, she said, I'm going to get skinny for you. I'm like, I don't really care about skinny. How about naked? Can we? Skinny can take years. Naked we can do right now. I don't really care. I'm just saying. There's very little sex happening. At this point, I'm thinking of donating my penis to science. Just so eventually someone else will touch it again. Breastfeeding, like, killed her sex drive. I'm the same guy. I want to have sex every day. She wants to have sex, never. So, we have settled on almost never. Then she actually asked me the other day, why do you watch porn? What do you mean, why? So I don't kill one of us, that's why. I'm leaning towards you, by the way. There's still hope for me. I can get a hug in jail or something. Somebody would love me somewhere. Now, once you become a dad, you hear stuff you didn't even notice before. I was watching Oprah. She was warning parents about the dangers of marshmallows. Some kid choked or whatever. Now, I don't mean to seem insensitive, but if your kid cannot survive a marshmallow, maybe we don't need him. Grow up to cure cancer? He's probably not going to live through the pencil. I think we should distribute marshmallows to all of our children as an evolutionary speed bump to weed out the weak before they procreate. And if you don't know what procreate means, please tomorrow pick yourself up a bag of marshmallows. So Karen and I are trying to figure out how to compromise more. It's hard when we live with somebody, right? That's how it works in our relationship. She wants A, right? And I want Z. So we settle on B. Well played. We're trying to eat better, too. She brought home something called vegetarian meatballs, which is not even possible. I'm standing there reading the box like, oh my God, these are going to suck. And it occurs to me, you have to call them that, because you can't call them vegetarian balls. Those do not exist. They've withered away from an absence of protein. They have been replaced with soy nuts. Then we have vegan dessert. I mean, I know what vegan means, but I think it might be a French word for disappointing. She was mad at her mom. I hear people say that. She goes, if I turn on my mom, just shoot me. I'm like, honey, I love you. I really really do. But if you turn to your mother, I am not going to be within shooting distance. I want to help a girl out. I'll mail bomb you, but I'm not going to. Did I mention there's no sex? Couldn't find our G-spot anyway. I was beginning to think it might be one of those silent G's, like in the word gnat. Men think about sex every 8 seconds. Wow. Yet another area where I'm above average. Every 8 seconds. Maybe that's why they only make bull riders ride for that long. Any longer, their minds wander, they'll get themselves killed. It's Ben 8. Send the clown in there. Get him off of that thing. Every 8 seconds. How do we get anything done ever as a civilization? How do you focus on any task? I am building the bridge. I gotta see me some titties. I wouldn't even build a stupid bridge, man, except all the titties are on the other side of the river. Kara's cool, man. I was flipping around TV, I actually saw her on Sabrina, the Teenage Witch, the other day. Cat's talking to her, she's cooking dinner. I was like, this show is not realistic. This woman does not cook dinner. We have a rule, it's okay to be mean to each other as long as it's funny, which sounds like a good rule, but she is wicked mean and hilarious. I got a gut. She didn't get a part she really wanted. She came home, she was bummed out. I go, so who got the part? She goes, I don't know. Someone looks like me, but 15 years ago. And I said, oh, do you have her number? You know the rule. Here's a story about us. We were going to from New York City to Vermont on a Friday in a car. From New York City in a car on a Friday. And I want to leave early to avoid traffic. And Caroline said, I don't think traffic's going to be that bad. I know. She seems smart, right? I'm afraid of getting bum rushed. I don't know. This is a true story. I'm not exaggerating this. I want to leave at 11 a.m. She wanted to leave at 2 p.m. We agreed on 2. Also, absolutely true. She was not ready. We left at 3:30. So we're sitting in traffic for like 5 hours, and I ate a granola bar, and she goes, was that the only one? How come you didn't offer me a bite? And I said, oh, I'm sorry. I didn't want you to be happy. And that made her laugh, and then I laughed, and we weren't pissed anymore. See? You know the story. I got a fortune cookie, I think describes my approach to the whole thing. It said, life's a tragedy for those who feel, and a comedy for those who think. It's true, man. Life is terrible. And it's wonderful. It's all in how you look at it, you know? Tennis example. A guy was watching a soccer game. His wife came in and changed the channel. They got into a fight. He killed her. Watched the rest of the game, and then called the police. All right. That's terrible. But I cut that article out, and I put it on the refrigerator, and now I can watch whatever I want.